mornings and afternoon, after morning, evening for all those here. Thanks for being here, Duck Pond and Drina. Appreciate the company and the support. We'll be continuing our wonderful Halloween quests. This one's Stemming the Skeletal Tide. We'll see if this is the only one we do tonight, or if there are others we'll end up doing. But yeah, pretty excited to continue before the festival events really truly begin. And we'll see how things go. Kind of trucking right along after after work every day, trying to get streams in right after finishing the shift at work, and it's been going pretty okay. The brain is a little bit mushy, but I guess that's to be expected. Hope you're all doing okay. Looks like we have to use the everlasting mob stopper. I suppose we'll pack up on heroes. See how this goes here. So, because Mad King Thorn still doesn't believe, even after summoning seven planeskeepers, I forget what they're called already, to tell him that Doom is returning, we are now going to find physical evidence of this return. We shall see how it goes. Trash, that's okay. We shall see how it goes here. Let's begin. Our goal is to use the everlasting mob stopper to trap the spirit of a weakened skeleton of doom. Onward. Lots of question marks on the screen. Oh dear, and we have hidden dialogue that we're not supposed to be seeing because of the lore through. Please ignore everything you see on the screen. Disregard. Let's see. Go back to Stemming the Skeletal Tide. Where are they located? Literally one right here? Okay. Or supposedly speaking. Let's find out. Got him. Alright. You're overcome by the energy coming off the everlasting mob stopper holding your newly captured skeleton of doom. You couldn't possibly handle capturing another one while in this state. Okay. I guess we're ready for bringing the captured skeleton to the Mad King Steward. That was fast. Yes, 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 yes. Mad King Steward. You do come through in a pinch. Now to convince Mad King Thorn and determine how Doom's slumber may be extended indefinitely. My thanks, mortal. Alright. That's out of the way. Every bit helps. The Mad King, whom I serve most obediently, appears more concerned about dripping pie filling on his invisible pony than the possible return of Doom. Though I am unworthy to speculate about the thickness of his head, I can see in his empty eyes that he doesn't consider one skeleton evidence of an uprising. Would you mind capturing a few more of Doom's minions? Naturally, I will reward you for every batch of evidence you bring. You're all insane. Stay right here while I go away over there. I'm on my way. What's this other one? Okay. Alright. We'll get to that one after this one. Use the everlasting mob stoppers. We've got three of them this time. Bring three of them. Okay. Let's go ahead and sell at least two items back to the Temple of the Ages. So, Andrina, what are you up to? Dead immediately. Okay. I guess they can't be blocked? That's odd. I didn't know that bladed Atex could not be blocked. Okay. Very poorly executed on my part. That's okay. We will move on. That's one. Hello, more kills. Plan for Underworld right now. Welcome on in, by the way. Thanks for visiting. We're doing festival quests right now. Welcome on in, more kills and Foxgloves. Thanks for being here. Thanks for visiting. Thanks for the support. Let's see what we've got going on here. Festival. Yep, we are capturing skeletons to bring to the Mad King Steward to try to convince the Mad King Thorn that Doom is on his way. Halloween quests. But we are doing festival quests. So we've got the Everlasting Mob Stoppers. I have to capture two more Skeletons of Doom. Following what you're suggesting. I'm just capturing three of these and moving on. We're doing a lore through. We're not really here for profiting. We're just having a fun time. I can go out and in, but I appreciate it. You've got the right idea. That's two. But yeah, thanks for visiting on in. Appreciate the company and support. How's everybody doing here? Skeleton of Doom. Got him. Let's head back on over. To Lion's Arch.
Well done. On behalf of my liege, I thank you. The more crystallized skeletons I show him, the brighter his candle burns. For this reason, my offer remains open. Capture more minions and claim more rewards.
Alright.
Faced with overwhelming evidence, the Mad King has conceded his sense of impending doom was due to... well, you get the picture. But I fear this realization is all for naught. Though Mad King Thorn has the ability to appear in this world each autumn, his power over the mortal realm is limited. He informs me his strength within the underworld is weaker still. As the Mad King's steward, I cannot do much more than sweep up his crumbs and groom his invisible pony. So it seems we can offer no further assistance. You and the others of your realm must face the return of doom. If you wish to hold back the coming night, seek out the voice of Grenth and offer your assistance.
It will be done. I shall speak with the voice of Gwenth.
Thanks for nothing. I think I'll go find a nice place to cry. let's see. Volunteer services in the fight against doom. Let's see, what's this one called? Able to enter with the Transmogrifier Tonic on this one? Let's see. No. Enter the underworld and speak with Reaper of the Labyrinth. Complete all 10 quests. I will tell you, we don't have time for this tonight. And I'm wondering... I'm wondering even if we have enough time to actually do it at all before Halloween is over. This is the big, big quest. And we're probably not going to do it, honestly, to be very honest, even though we're trying to do lore throughs. Let's see where we're at. Nope. Well, I know these streams are a little bit shorter than normal, but we're just trying to wrap up with the Halloween events. Unfortunately, this particular event is just to get a stack of trick-or-treat bags, honestly. And let's read the dialogue here. And if you want to do the quest, then that's on you. Voice of Grenth, the time is nigh. Doom stirs. Who else is here? Up on the quest here. Yeah, this is a little bit outside of my comfort zone, I'm sorry to say. I think what I'll try to do... Maybe we can try to get this done tomorrow, the 30th of October? I'll have to read up a bit and do a little bit of extra research, but... perhaps we can try to fill in a couple extra minutes. I didn't know that particular quest, I didn't know it was going to be that short-lived. Maybe we can try... Let's go ahead and switch over to our main. Give me just a minute here. And we'll switch over to main. Let's see. Go ahead and see if we can do Abaddon's Mouth while we're here. Get some of that out of the way. Okay. Impressive. To sell. And now we will talk to Blade Warrior Olivio to continue on from where we left off with our last lore bit. You have made many allies from all across Tyria. I am proud to be among them and to have come this far with you. I am at your service. What can I help you with? What do you know about the Dwarf Kamali? I know that it's in the most treacherous part of the volcano, deep in the caldera known as Abaddon's Mouth. I know that behind it lies the only chance we have of defeating the Mursat. What do you think is behind there? I've heard the legends, but I can't honestly say for sure. It's apparently strong enough to withstand the heat of the volcano. Whatever it is, it frightens the Mursat so much that they're not willing to take any chances with it. The legends? What legends? As the story goes, behind the Door of Komali is a gateway to another realm. Some say it leads to the Hall of the Heroes. Others say it goes farther than that, penetrating deep into the mists, deep into the Sanctum of the Gods and their angelic disciples. How much farther to the door? Not far now. We're about halfway to the caldera. But this may be the most treacherous stretch of land that you've encountered. Between here and Abaddon's Mouth stands the Onyx Gate. I've not seen it myself, but it's the Mursat's most highly guarded outpost. This is one of their last lines of defense. If you can make it past the gate, then all that stands between you and your new allies is the Door of Komali. What must I do? Make your way up the volcano into Abaddon's Mouth and open the Door of Komali. Vizier Kilbron will show you the way. Wish me luck. You'll need more than luck. We'll need henchmen. Let's begin. And see where we get. Onward to the Onyx Gate.
silly, silly. Silly. Alright, let's begin. Zero energy. That's not good. The mesmer we're dealing with? There we go. Sat garments. So what's everyone's plans for the night? Haven't heard from y'all for a bit. Hope we're doing good. Eventually I'll be sure to add Twitch chat to the stream, perhaps. Let's see. Here's the gate. A heavily guarded gate. Those were armors. I thought those were... Wait a minute. Why am I not paying attention? The brain is dead, I swear. Those folks are coming up the stairs. Thank you. Okay, Sarlacc the Judge, let's see what you got for us here. Garcia the Smug is down. Gate is open. I think there's a person named Loretta Stone in this mission. Bonus, let's see, what is this called? Abaddon's Mouth. Abaddon's Mouth. Leia Stone. Okay, I was close, not Loretta. I'm not sure. Essentially, the idea is that we have to escort the spirit of Leia Stone from the fortress to a small island in the west. She only appears once the ether seal at the docks near the spawn point is defeated. The main difficulty is that she's fragile and can be easily killed, stops moving if you move out of compass range, and she slows down once she leaves the fortress. She's affected by burning. This is... We have the option of freeing her. She was killed on the one of the bloodstones by the White Mantle, and their spirit's been trapped for quite some time, but all the dark magic draining her soul's energy. She doesn't want her final resting place to be at the fortress. There's a small island to the west that makes her reminds her of Loamhurst. Take her there, be at peace, and pull from the pull of this vile place, she says. My soul is free. Thank you. I can finally be at peace. We're not going to do that bonus because of the difficulty with henchmen. But we are going to maybe revisit that at some point for a bit of added lore and whatnot. This Mursoc monk, I think, is going to run away from us, or fly, float away from us. I'm going to continue on towards where we're at here. Waste.
Vizier says, the Mersat now know you are the ones to fulfill the Flameseeker prophecies. They will do anything in their power to keep you from reaching the caldera. Why will they do this? Shall we? Definitely a well-guarded area, huh? Bothered with us. We're just going to face these four jade armors, I suppose. Miss Caleb and Willa the Unpleasant. I suppose have some things to say. Let's talk to Willa first. Willa. Give a bit of love to Optimus Caleb. Burning away, and now we target. Come on, heal me. Come on. almost there. Vizier Kilbron, what say you? Why aren't you happy, Vizu? Not happy with what I'm doing right now. Close to the stuff there. Turn to these folks. Oh, that hurt. Oh, that hurts a lot. We might not make it, my friends. Well, we're going to try that mission again some other time, and we're going to have to probably request the help of non-heroes. Those people, those fools are not dying fast enough. Oh, dear. But all right. That was a fun try. Not going to make it. Very much not going to make it. And, thanks for all visiting tonight. We're going to try that mission again. I think what we'll do is I'm going to recruit some people maybe next time we try to do this mission, and then we'll do both the mission and the bonus together, perhaps. But in the meantime, thank you all for being here. It was a good shot. Let's see. Let me tell this person, sorry, we're not going to be doing the mission here. Head it out for the night. Best of luck and have a good one. But Andrina, Foxgloves, anyone else? Duck Pond, everyone else who's watching, have a wonderful evening. And we'll catch you all around on the next time. Have a good night.